Okay, this is Claude and Brian. Brian's in Florida, and we're going to make phone calls here, and we are recording today, Wednesday, July 8th. Can you type in the phone numbers on your area there so I don't have to erase them later? Oh, you did this already. God, are you efficient? Okay, let's go for it. And you guys who are going to watch this, if we're going to use this for Brian's webpage. And this one's in Delray, Florida, right? I know nothing about this property other than the phone number, right? Is this from a paper or a Zillow? Yeah, hi, Barry. Yeah, hi, Barry. Claude Diamond here. I'm in Winter Park, Colorado. My friend Brian just gave me your phone number. You got a property out there? Is it still available? Can you tell me a little bit about it? I don't know much about it. Brian just called me. He knew I was looking for an investment property out there. Lakes of Delray. Okay.
Okay, zip code 33484.
Three. Oh, I'm sorry. You said a code 33.
Zip code is 33484.
Okay. Thank you.
All right. Now, I'm sorry. Now, what's your first name?
My first name is Claude, and yours is?
Barry Feldman.
Hi, Barry. Claude Diamond here.
Okay.
I'm in Colorado.
What a diamond.
Yes, sir. Like a diamond ring. You have any family in New Jersey? I used to have a Feldman family in New Jersey.
They're all over the place now.
Particularly Florida, right?
Huh?
Especially in Florida.
Especially in Florida. Parts of Florida. Other parts, Feldman's not allowed.
You can it's easy to get a minion, right?
Yeah, sure. But listen, Floyd, it was my in-laws' place.
Okay.
Okay. Now, background for me is that I was a broker in the state of New York for 26 years.
Oh, wonderful.
Past real estate broker, so we're talking on the same level.
Ex exactly. I'm a recovering attorney and a real estate investor, and my friend Brian Catano down there just gave me your number.
Okay, we've got it's second floor, beautiful lake view. No bullshit. I mean, this is straight talk. You're not gonna go there and see a swamp with frogs. Okay, it's beautiful lake view. It's built in 1990. It's elevated, an elevator place. They have elevators and lifts in some places. This has got an elevator. In Lakes of Delray, Lakes of Delray is an excellent condo community. There's no villas, there's no single family houses, just condos, and it's not gigantic. Yet it does have a full-size clubhouse. It's got the shows that all the others have. It's got the pool tables, seven or eight pool tables and a snooker table. It's got
So this is a condo.
yeah.
Okay. How many square
I'm
feet?
telling you about the area.
I know.
Lakes of Delray. Now, it's the condo itself, 1,150 square feet. All
Okay.
right.
And two bedrooms, three.
Two bedrooms, two baths, two full baths. One's a tub shower combo, and the other, all one thing, and the other one's a stall shower, walk-in stall shower. New paint,
Okay.
carpet in the living room, excellent quality carpet, excellent quality padding too.
Okay, it sounds like it's in really good shape. Is it vacant or occupied right now?
It's occupied. I got a renter in there now.
Okay, good for you.
Now, here's the thing. From what I understand from the association, that when their lease is up, once it's sold, it's like a 2-year wait until you can re-rent.
Correct.
Okay?
Okay, so you don't want to push them out unless you got a sale.
Even with the sale, I really don't want to push them out.
No, I don't.
I want to be fair with them.
No, you want to be smart too. I wouldn't do anything different than you're doing, actually.
Yeah, truthfully, they're good people.
Why sell it then? Why not just keep renting it? Sounds like you got a good tenant in there and it's paying for itself.
Yeah, it is. It's going off for us. We have no mortgage. It's going off, $600 a month. We've got a loan that we've got to satisfy for
$220,000. Oh, a HELOC or something? Yeah, that's okay. You said you had no mortgage, but you have a lien on it for something else.
No, not on that one. Not on that one. I'm talking about me and my motivation. Not that. That's pretty clear.
Oh, okay. Okay. So you need for all deeds and purposes, you need all cash.
Yeah.
Okay. Make it interesting for me.
Okay. It's 1,008, and.
1,008. What do you mean?
108,000.
Okay, is the purchase price?
Yeah.
Okay, is that market value, undervalue, over? Give me an idea.
The value, according to Zillow and according to the comps and so forth, the market value is 1,400.
You lost me. 100.
What? $114,000.
Let me just ask you the million-dollar question here. What would be the least you'd take for an all-cash deal 30-day close?
All-cash deal 30-day close.
You can think on it and call me back.
No. We'll see that.
Either look for price or terms. I'm just going to be very straightforward. I love investment properties in Florida. So I can do the cash for a wholesale deal. I can do a little bit higher if someone holds the mortgage or something like that. But that wouldn't work because you got a good tenant in there already.
Yeah.
I might even leave the tenant in there, actually.
Well, they probably would like that.
Yeah.
They're really good.
So we're talking strictly a cash deal here. With no realtor, quick close, and I can do that. You can look me up on the internet, Claude Diamond, on Facebook or on my webpage.
Okay.
I'm a straight shooter.
Okay, let me see now. Okay. I want to be able to walk away with. Okay, after closing, I want to be able to walk away with 100.
Yeah, it won't work for me. I appreciate that, though. You know, my head was thinking 75 to make it so I can make a profit on it too and turn it into a rental.
75 would be way below.
Yeah, no, I respect that. You know, I'm not trying to bully you or anything like that.
No. Just a bunch of guys trying to figure out where
Yeah, I'm just really straightforward with people, right to the point. I'm a New Yorker. You know what we sound like.
Yeah.
I'm a New Yorker who they let into Colorado.
same thing. I'm from upstate New York.
Oh, okay. I'm from the city.
Not the
Delaware
area.
Yeah. Let me do this. What's your email address? What's your email address again?
Okay, it's mail, just like post office. M-A-I-L. The number 4. Mail 4. Cells,
F like in
Frank,
ELD, mail4cells
@yahoo.com.
Yahoo.com, got it. Let me do this. And what's the, I want to look on this property. It's on Zillow, you said?
It's on Zillow.
Well, what's the street? Google Earth. What's the street or address there?
Oh, okay. 15301 Cambridge. P like in Peter, Embridge, Bembridge Avenue, B, Pembridge Avenue, Delray Beach, 33484, Delray Beach, Florida, 33484.
484. Let me do this. You have my phone number there on your caller ID.
Give me it again.
Brian.
Yeah.
Give me your number, Brian. So he's, I'm on the phone here with Brian. He's my agent, my representative out there. What's your phone number, Brian?
561-299-0042.
What company do you work for?
Well, Diamond Consulting Group is the name of my company. We've been 30 years in business. But if you just go on ClaudeDiamond.com, you can find everything you want about me. I'm a pretty open book.
Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Listen, by the way, I have to be a home inspector.
Oh, wonderful. So the house is in first-class shape.
It is.
Oh, I love that.
Yeah, if you find something, whatever, there was one pull chain on a fan that wasn't working. I went ahead and I bought it and put it in.
That's...
There was a switch that went there.
You know exactly what to look for, then.
Yeah, I've been doing it for over 19 years, and I was a general contractor for 28 years in upstate New York.
Wow, what a background. You got a great real estate background.
Broker for 26 years, yeah.
Are you doing stuff in Florida still?
Just home inspections. We've got a home inspection company, Sheldon Building Inspections.
Things are starting to turn around down there, aren't they?
Huh?
You're getting a little action down there, finally.
Feldman Building
Inspections.
In fact, if you want to look on my website. It's Feldman Inspections.
Feldman.
FeldmanInspections.com.
Oh, easy. I love it. FeldmanInspections.com. I'll tell you what we're going to do, Mr. Feldman. I'm going to look this over. I'm going to send you a letter or something today. And let's see if we can return to this. If not, we'll do business with something else then.
Yeah, let's start to do business, generate some serious money.
Sounds good, sir.
Buying and selling, renting and fixing, whatever it may be.
Yeah, I've got the cash and credit and stuff. But you know, when I buy a property, I buy it to make it into an investment with a return.
Absolutely, that's the way to do it.
Yeah, and I love Florida and all that. You're a gentleman, sir. Thank you for your time.
Thank you. Same here. Let's see if we can do something.
Okay. Take care, sir. Bye-bye.
Take care. Bye-bye.
So what did you take from that?
Well, owner finance deal, but it doesn't sound like he really wants to come down to your number.
Well, he doesn't want to come down yet. I mean, we just got started. Did you see some guts in that conversation?
I sure did.
What did you see me do? First of all, give me an analysis of my style. Did you listen to the words I used? What was I trying to do here? Give me an analysis.
Well, you were building. It was more like he became a friend of yours.
Whoa.
The way you were speaking to
Why him. Is that important in terms of persuasion, Dr. Cialdini?
It's very important when you want people to be able to negotiate with you.
That's right. Did you see how much information I got?
Yeah.
How long was I on the phone with him? About 8-9 minutes?
Yeah, I didn't see what time we started the call at.
Okay, all I've got to do, and these are the conversations I have. He said the magic words. I tried to wave my hands or something. I went like this. Did you? What was the magic word he said?
I don't remember what he said.
Free and?
Oh, yeah, the free and clear, yeah.
I think he said it was, did he say it was his brother's property or father's or
something?
In-laws property, free and clear. Now, he's got a tenant in there. They're paying on time and they love the place. What am I going to do? Get them to move out? Or he doesn't want them to move out unless he knows he's got a sale.
Right.
What I would suggest to you is to one of two things. Did you see all the information? I put all his contact information in there. I want you to send him a letter of intent today. Very short, two parts. Claude said he really enjoyed, I'm his contact down there. He mentioned me during the phone call. Here, two offers we'd like to tender, either $75,000 cash on the property 30-day close, or we'll give you the $100,000, but you have to hold the mortgage for 5 years, principal only payments.
Okay,
I like the print. I'll give him the $100,000, but I want $1,000 down, $1,000 a month, principal only payments. I'll pay him in full. I'll pay him for the next 100 months, $1,000 a month.
Maybe. So you would offer $1,000 down and 100, how much a month did you say?
$1,000 down, $1,000 a month for 100 months. That's, want to see, would you like that? Or 60 months, if we could come back down to 60 months and then pay off the balloon and put cash in his pocket. So we would pay off $60,000, give him $40,000 at the end of 5 years, cash. What's going to happen in 5 years to this property?
Go up.
Hopefully.
Yeah.
I don't know what the rent is on the thing. I should have asked him that. Did you hear him? Did he mention that?
He didn't mention anything about a rent.
Okay.
Just see if people in there.
So I want you to send him a letter of intent, one page, real simple. I want you to insert that as a PDF in a iJot, a video email. You can do that on QuickTime also, or there's many other. I like iJot. I've always talked about it. And then I want you to say, Claude just asked me to call you. I've attached an offer here, a letter of intent. Please feel free to get back to me. I live in Florida nearby, and we're open to discussion on this property. You have a nice day.
Okay.
And we take all the information we have. We put it in Evernote. We send them this. We put a copy of the offer into Evernote. Maybe we contact him in 30. What would you say? On a 1 through 10, what would you give this guy? He said something else very important.
I would say right around 5. Maybe 6.
I think it was more like a 7. He said he has another, it was hard to hear, maybe. He said he had a $220,000 HELOC or home equity loan or something like that on some other, for some other thing. This property was free and clear, but he owed $220,000, I thought he said.
He said that number, but I don't see how he could have that on that property, because that property...
He doesn't have it on that property. It's on another property. Okay. It was on something else. It was a little confusing. I had trouble... I was confused, too, if you listen to the complete audio. So he's a little more, for some reason, that's a strain on his budget. He wants to pay that down or get rid of it partially. Okay. So if I give him $1,000 a month, he can catch up on his payments. Maybe he's behind. Maybe it's just a strain on his budget. Or I can give him all cash, $75,000. You know, if he had a realtor in this deal, no one's going to give him. He wanted, I think it's worth $114,000, he said. Was that right? He would take $100 on a cash deal. My number is $75. I can't do it for less than $75. It's just not enough. If I can't make $25,000 to $35,000 on a condo, and this is assuming, you know, this is all subject to an inspection and location and this thing is 25 years old.
Yeah.
So, but he's got a tenant in there. He sounded like a straight shooter. He was not a dummy. He was a broker from upstate New York. He was also a home inspector. He was a good guy.
Yeah.
And did you see how I tried to get an adult-to-adult conversation? Very honest, very straightforward, right to the point.
Yeah.
In 8 to 10 minutes, we were negotiating a deal. So listen to this video. I think there was a lot to be learned in this one video, in this one recording, about... taking a cold call, calling a person, trying to get – the power of persuasion is likability, trust. You get those things by not sounding like the other 99% out there. And you – can you imagine if you did 5 phone calls like this a day? And this was the first one you gave me.
Hey, a bunch more if you want.
I mean, if anyone's watching this, we can use this as a promotional video for you. Was this the first phone call you gave me?
Yes, it was.
And where did you get it from?
Zillow.
And the guy, God forbid, the guy picked up the phone. We got the person right off Zillow. We had a conversation. Do you think he's going to remember me?
Oh, yeah.
Are you going to follow up today?
Yeah.
And then we organize it. We put it in our backup. And maybe something good will happen. If you do, it's not a numbers game when you work this smart. The numbers, the law of averages, the statistics are in your favor now.
Yeah.
And then all you got to do is talk to people nicely, I think, and you can go to the bank like crazy.
Yeah, I spoke to another guy this morning.